Hey y'all, it's Diane with Shaw Craft One and my old barn door and barn door treasures on eBay. I bet you're wondering what this mess is on my desk. Well, I thought we could do a journal with things that we have probably an abundance of after the holiday season. If you're like me, when you do your Christmas shopping, you order a lot of things to be shipped, and so you have all of this shipping packaging left over. And so I thought, I really don't want to throw it away because this is great paper. So we're going to make a journal with it. A quick and easy journal, a no-so journal, which is even better. So if you want to learn how to do that, stick around because we're going to start right now. Okay, so the first thing I do is I lay out all of my shipping papers. I lay them out flat and I just kind of flatten them out. And it's okay if some of them are ripped. That's not a problem at all. And so then the next thing that I do is I want to decide what I want my cover to be. And Mom, every year, she makes Chex Mix for all her family because they all love it. And her grandkids really, really love it. Like Alex, the little boy, he can eat a whole tub in one sitting. He loves it that much. So anyways, so I had some of the cereal boxes left, and so I thought I cut out some recipes off the back, but I thought we could use this as a journal cover. So I'm going to trim this down and get the edges straight, and then we'll move forward. Okay, so now I have the trim down, and it's going to be the cutest little journal. I can't wait to get started. So once I have this trimmed down to the size journal that I want it to be, I'm going to sit it to the side, and then I'm going to start folding my papers, okay? So this is just going to make it a little bit easier for us to get our pages out of it, and I'm going to use my journal cover as a guide. So I want the pages to be a little bit shorter. Can y'all see okay? Let me just scooch down a little bit. I want my pages to be a little bit shorter than the cover, you know, so you have a little bit of room and it's not sticking out everywhere. So I'm thinking somewhere around this area. So I'm just gonna put a little mark there. Okay, and then I'm gonna take this. I'm going to fold it this way. Okay. And then it looks like I'm going to be able to have another portion, but this kind of doesn't have a straight edge. So I may just tear that portion off. And you don't really even have to use a trimmer. This paper is great because you can just tear it. So I'm just going to tear this off right here. Okay. And so you'll see there that we'll have a page. Alright, and then I'm going to take this and I'm going to put it up against my journal so that I kind of know. I guess it would help to put it on the top of the journal so that I kind of know where I need to trim it off at. And I'm just going to use my ruler right here and I'm going to tear. Okay, so this is actually going to give me two pages because it's folded double. So I'm going to go ahead and put my ruler here. And I'm going to tear. Okay, so now I already have two pages for my journal. So that's basically how I figure up my pages. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take all of this paper and I'm going to cut it down to the sizes of the pages that I need. So I think what I'll do is I'll let some music play so that you don't have to get bored watching me do all of this paper. So I've got all of my papers torn down to size, and I've put them in signature piles of, I think there's like seven, plus a couple of little short pieces in each one. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stack these, you know, just start stacking the signatures together so that they're all inside each other to make a signature. So I'll do that, and then we'll go to the next step. All right, and then once you get them done, we have six signatures, and each signature has about 10 pages in it. Okay, and so I'm just gonna tuck it right in there and show you what it's gonna look like inside our journal cover. So the next thing we need to do before we put our signatures in, and I love how it's already, you know, kind of filled up. So, but before we put our signatures in, we need to do the cover. So, I'm going to take my signatures and sit them to the side, and then we're going to do a simple, cover for the cover. So I'm just going to take some pretty paper and cover the journal cover with it. And I have this that I think, is what I want to use. So it's not quite wide enough to go all the way across. So I'll show you how we fix that, so to speak. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a piece and I'm going to measure it to go probably to about, let me see. I'm probably going to take it about the middle of the spine, because we're going to cover the spine with something else so you won't see where it joins. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to line this up on my lines on my my cutting mat here so that I can get everything straight, and I'm going to go out about a half an inch, maybe a little further out the edge excuse me, so that I have something to fold over. Oh, excuse me. I don't know why. All of a sudden got a tickle in my throat. Okay, so I'm just going to tear this. And then I'm going to tear up here as well. Just leaving enough to fold in to the journal. So we're going to take that off. And so then we have our piece. And this piece is... well, it's not going to matter because you may use something different. Okay, and then I do want, I want this to be on my cover because I like the flowers, the roses, pretty roses. And so, but I'll, sometimes if you just glue directly on this, it doesn't stick as well. So I'm just going to run the sanding paper across this fairly quickly, just to give it a little bit of a rough edge, so that it has a tooth, you know, for the paper and the glue to hold to. So just a very quick run over it with the sanding block. And then you want to wipe all that sanding dust off of your mat and off of your cereal box. And it can be whatever kind of box you have. It doesn't have to be a cereal box. All right, so then I'm just going to take my glue. And I have my little, where's my paintbrush here? Where'd he go? Here we go. And I'm just going to put glue. And this is just my homemade Mod Podge. So I'm just going to glue the cover. Okay. I'm going to wipe that excess glue off with my paper towel just so my paper doesn't stick to it. And then I'm just going to lay my paper down about halfway in the center of the spine, making sure I get it straight. And then I'm just going to burnish it onto that with my bone folder. Make sure you get it all the way to the edges and the corners. Okay, and then we're going to flip this over. Wipe any excess glue away again so you don't, because your paper will stick to that glue and it'll tear it. Okay, and then I'm going to take my scissors and miter the corners here. Okay. And then we're going to just put some glue down on each side. I'm sure y'all have all seen this. You know how to do it. And then we're just going to fold this into the glue. Like that. Fold the bottom up into the glue. Sorry, I'm not in center. Okay, and then we're going to fold this piece in too. And it gives us the nice, neat little corners. Now, if you have a problem folding your corners, if you take your bone folder and you just push the edge of this in just a little on each side, and then you can just fold that up like so if you need to get a good fold. And see how neat it makes the corners of it? And then you just want to rub that down into the glue. Okay, now I'm going to do this other side like this and I'll be right back. Okay, so I have both the front and the back cover done. So now we're going to put something on the inside cover. And I think we're just going to use the pieces that we tore off of those pages. Or not. They might not be big. Yep, those are big enough. So we'll use those pieces. Okay. So again, you just want to measure and make sure that it's, you know, the right size. And this is. So that makes it really, really easy. I think I'm going to do it this way. So I'm just going to glue these down into the inside of the cover. Okay. So once you get your inside cover on, I usually put my heat gun to it just a little bit, just to kind of, it's going to warp a little because you're using wet glue, but you can work it back into size once you get it put together and start using it. All right, so once you get your inside and your outside covers on, you want to go ahead and crease the folds again. So just gently lift up the edge here, and I always take my ruler and put it up against where the fold is, because that natural fold will reveal itself, so to speak. And so if you put your ruler up there, you can kind of hold your paper down so it doesn't bend it, you know, or crease it in the wrong way. And then I just kind of rub my cover like this, just giving it some gentle pressure so that that crease is a little easier to bend. And then we're going to do the same thing on this side. See, once I lifted that side up, you can see where the crease is supposed to be. So we're just going to take our ruler and just rub gently like so. And then you have your journal cover. Super cute, hey? Okay, so then once you get your journal cover covered, got it upside down, then we're going to take our signatures and we're going to put them in our journal. And we're going to do this with what's called the easy twine binding. So you're just going to use twine and you don't have to sew. So I have this pink and white twine here on a spool, and I'm actually just going to leave it on the spool. I'm not going to measure, and that way I know exactly how much I'm going to need, and it works out a little better. So basically what I'm going to do, since I have six signatures, I'm going to wrap my spine and make sure that I have a spot for six signatures to fit into. And let me just, probably be easier for you if I just show you. So I'm going to take my twine. The first thing I'm going to do is tie a little knot at the end of it, and that just kind of helps it to not unravel in the future. So it just kind of keeps your twine in place, okay? So you're going to lay the twine on the outside of your spine, okay? And then you're going to just wrap it around, okay? Just wrap it around your spine. You can unroll some from your spool, okay? So you're just going to keep wrapping it around. Sorry if I'm bumping the camera. Okay, so that gives me four in there, and I need six, so we're going to spread these over a little. We're just going to scoot them over. So I just need two more wraps. I'm gonna unroll some more twine and I'm gonna wrap. There's 5 and 6. Okay, so that gives me a spot inside for 6 signatures. Okay, and then once I get my 6 times wrapped, I'm gonna scoop my signatures over and lay this down like so, and I'm gonna kind of keep it tight because you want it to be, you know, pretty tight so that you can have that security, you know, so it'll be secure. All right, so here's your 2 ends. Okay, you're just gonna take these and cross them over like this. Okay, and then once you cross them over, you're gonna take this end that you tied a knot on and you're just gonna run it underneath all of your strings, okay, like so. And what that's gonna do is it's gonna gather in the center there. And then you're just gonna tie it off. And I usually tie either 2 or 3 times just to make sure it's good and secure, just like so. There we go. And then I'm just gonna snip this end off. And I'm gonna tie a knot here too so that this side doesn't unwind. Just like so. And then we have a spot for all of our signatures to go in. So now I'm just gonna make sure that I kind of space out my twine. I just kind of like to get it evenly spaced out. Doesn't have to be perfect, okay? So that's what the inside is gonna look like. And then all you have to do is you take your signatures, 1 signature at a time. You find the center of your signature. This is the center of mine. Okay, and then I'm just going to, I usually find that it's a little easier to put the corner under the twine first, and then I can just pull right like so. And then you can just kind of get it to line up. There you go. There's 1 signature. We'll go ahead and do a couple more on video. Finding the center. I'm trying to stack them up neatly, but it doesn't have to be super neat unless you want it to be. I'm more of an imperfect, you know, I like the imperfectness. Here, I'll bring this down a little closer where you can see. I like the imperfections in a journal, so I'm okay if it's wrinkled or if it's, you know, but you can make it neater if you want to. It's completely your choice and it's a personal preference. Okay, so then we're gonna find the center of this one. Oh, I just had the center. No, I didn't. There we go, okay. So I'm gonna just kind of stack them and make sure they're lining up good in the fold. And then I'm gonna pull my string up, tuck that corner underneath, and that way I can kind of just finagle it in there. And the good thing about this twine binding, now you can sew these signatures, and generally I would sew the signatures just to keep them in place a little better, but they're gonna stay in place just fine if you don't wanna sew it. And you'll be just fine. So don't worry about it if you don't want to sew. I just like that as a preference. So I'm going to get the rest of these in and then we'll come back. Okay, so I have the rest of my signatures in. So as you can see, it looks like that. I love the way it's turned out. And so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to turn it over here to my spine. Okay, and then I'm just going to spread my twine back out and just kind of scoot it around until it has the look that I'm going for, because I kind of want this to be right in the middle. And I mean, again, this is a personal preference. It's all up to you. I just like to have them evenly spread out, or somewhat evenly spread out. It's not going to be perfect because nothing I ever do is perfect. Okay, so let's go this way, spread that one there. Super easy, super simple, and you have a cute little journal to work in. You can decorate the cover. You can decorate the pages on the inside. I think what I'm going to do with this little journal is I'm going to make it a faith journal or a scripture journal, and I'm going to write in it for 2022. I'm going to choose scriptures to put in here, scriptures that speak to me, things that mean something to me. And I may do videos on, I think I will do videos on it. I just don't know if I'll do them every week or every month or how I'll do that. But I will do some sharing in my faith journal with y'all. So I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial. Hope you have fun making a little journal of your own. I love, love, love the torn edged look on the top and the bottom. It just gives it that wonderful handmade effect, and I just absolutely love that. So if you have any suggestions for scriptures or ways that you would embellish this, leave it in the comment box below. Don't forget to like and subscribe for me if you will, and I hope you make a journal of your own like this. Just have fun with it. It takes very little time, and then you've got a super cute little journal that you get to play in. So I hope y'all have a great day. Big hugs.